It's FPV has released their new frame, the Era Deathcat, a 5.5-inch copter specifically designed for cinematic flights. I got the O4 version and tested it for 2 weeks. In this video, I'll introduce the frame, share my experiences, show cinematic footage, and talk about who this frame is suitable for. The frame comes with the following components: one cinematic nylon camera cage, two front arms, 6mm, two back arms, 6mm, two back arm braces, 6mm, one bottom plate, front, 2.5mm, one bottom plate, back, 2mm, one arm connector, 2mm, one top plate, 2mm, one interlock. All carbon parts are made from extremely stiff material. According to its FPV, they are up to 55% stronger than traditional FPV frames. The hardware includes frame screws, motor screws, flight controller ESC screws, standoffs, press nuts, and other small parts necessary for assembly. The frame also comes with the following 3D printed TPU parts: camera inserts for soft mounting the FPV camera, battery cable holder, VTX antenna holder. Additional accessories include 4 injection molded skids, 1 super sticky lipo pad, two nylon Kevlar battery straps, 250 millimeters. Optional parts are RX antenna mount, Era Chooch gloves, GPS mount, TBS, M10 GPS. These parts can either be purchased directly from its FPV or downloaded for free as 3D printing files from their website or Thingiverse. The links are in the video description below. By the way, I've also designed a few of my own parts for the Era Deathcat. I'll be showing them to you in a separate video soon. Assembling the frame is very simple. First, you mount the stack screws. Then, you need to press the 5 press nuts into the frame. These can easily be pressed in using a carbon arm and a screw. Once all 5 are inserted, you can place the interlock and the 4 arms on the bottom plate front. Then take the other bottom plate with the stack screws and place it on the arms. Insert the screws through everything and tighten them. the rear arms are reinforced with cross braces. Next, you mount the standoffs and the camera cage. The super sticky pad is attached to the top plate and then screwed onto the frame. There is also an instruction guide available on the It's FPV website, or you can watch an in-depth YouTube video of the complete drone build, including electronics and PID tuning. Additionally, a list of recommended parts can be found on rotorbuilds.com. The links are in the video description. When it comes to electronics, I went with all the recommended parts. The It's FPV 2208, 1750 kilovolt motors, and the T-Motor Velox F7, SE 50 ampere stack. After 2 weeks of flying, I'm still fully convinced by the product. The copter flies super smooth, and the frame quality is top-notch. I didn't have any hard crashes in these weeks, but the drone did fall twice from about 8 meters due to a wrongly set GPS configuration. Aside from a bit of dirt on the frame, there was no damage. I've been flying the predecessor to the Era Deathcat for half a year mainly for freestyle. And up until now, aside from the propellers, I haven't had to replace any parts. The quality from its FPV is, as always, excellent. The Era Deathcat is not just for cinematic flying. You can also freestyle and perform tricks with it. Additionally, you can cover quite a distance. With a 1,550 milliamp hour LiPo and no action cam, I achieved a flight time of almost 10 minutes and covered 7.3 kilometers distance. I'll definitely want to do a proper range test soon with a larger lithium-ion battery pack. The biggest plus point clearly goes to the quality of the frame. The carbon is super stable, the frame is high quality constructed, and the camera cage is durable, providing reliable protection for the FPV camera. Even the screws and other metal parts feel significantly more premium compared to other manufacturers. Its FPV is a German company founded by two pilots. They take care of everything themselves, from product development to quality control and shipping orders. This makes the company approachable and personable. What I also like about the frame and its FPV is that they are beginner-friendly. Its FPV provides very detailed videos that show how to build the frame, solder the components, and set up the copter. Additionally, you can download a lot of 3D models from its FPV or community accessories and 3D print them yourself. The biggest negative point for me is the price. The new Death Cat frames cost 109 euros or 129 US dollars, which puts them in the higher range of comparable frames. However, the price is definitely justifiable. The parts come from Germany, with corresponding quality. The frame was developed, constructed, and tested by only 2 people. Moreover, it's not industrial mass-produced, which naturally raises the price. Another point is the camera cage. It's very stable, but not quite as durable as the cage from the first frame generation. This is because the O4 cage was made using additive manufacturing, while the previous version was injection molded. You can especially notice this at the edges, where dents or indentations appear more easily. What I also find a bit unfortunate is that this frame no longer comes with motor cable protectors. The previous model included them, and I like them. That's why I designed my own. More on that in a future video. The frame does a bit of everything. You can use it for cinematic shots, mid-range flying, freestyle flying, chasing objects, slow flying, and much more. The setup covers a wide range of use cases and will stand out in my collection as a copter for almost everything. I especially recommend this frame to FPV beginners who already have a copter and now want to build their own for the first time. The assembly is simple, and there's a detailed video showing the installation of the electronics as well as PID tuning settings, including a list of recommended parts. Plus, you can crash with peace of mind, knowing that the frame is durable and won't break easily. I can also recommend the frame to experienced FPV pilots, as it offers a true high-end product. It's also perfectly suitable for professional use. The frame is reliable, you can achieve a great flight time, you get security from the GPS, and the copter covers many different use cases. That's it for this video. Feel free to leave a comment on what you think of the frame, and thanks for watching.